Church International. And we're blessed to have our General Overseer and other two pastors here with us today. On behalf of the family of the late Felicia Akyere Rockson, popularly known by those of us as Auntie Felicia, I just want to thank you all for coming out to join us in celebration and thanksgiving of the life of Auntie Felicia going home. We are gathered here to remember and to celebrate the precious life that we all have the opportunity to share with her while she was on earth with us. And also, I just want to thank each and every one of you for the precious memories that you've made. You know, the time that you've spent with Auntie, and pray that the Lord has given us the peace in His presence during this difficult time. As difficult as it is today, the scripture makes something very, very clear. If we look at Psalm 46, verse 1 and 2, it says that God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear. Even though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, we will not fail. The meeting this morning, as we are remembering Auntie Felicia, who is so loved, we are asking the Lord to give each one of us a different perspective, a perspective that will allow us or help us to grow in the truth of life, because we are here for a reason and a purpose, and that we will live here not the same as we came. Amen. I'd like to call Pastor Fred to give us our opening prayer.
Heavenly Father, we continue to give you all the glory, praise, and honor. This is the day you have made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Father, we thank you for your darling daughter, your dear daughter that you gave to the family, a daughter, a sister, a wife, a mother, an auntie, grandmother, great auntie, a neighbor, and a friend. Father, it is your word in the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse number 7. Now, Father, when you call us home, the spirit comes to you and the body goes back to the soil that it came from. Father, we thank you that today, as you call your daughter, your word is being fulfilled. And Father, we ask for the divine presence of your Holy Spirit to come and take absolute charge and absolute control. Now, Father, as we intend the body, your will be done. We thank you for all the loved ones that are here. Those that are on their way, Father, we pray that you bring them journey mercies to join us. The Father, at the beginning, we give you all the glory. And as the service is going on, all glory goes to you, Father. And as we finish here, and we fulfill your will be done. We thank you, Heavenly Father, Master Jesus, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray with thanksgiving, and the saints say, Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Pastor Fred. Please be seated. I'd like to call now, for us to have our Reverend Donald Harris, his son-in-law, and your beautiful, handsome son, Daniel.
Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself. That where I am, there you may be also.
For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so God will bring with him those who sleep in Jesus. For this we say to you, by the word of the Lord, that we are alive and remain until the coming of the Lord will by no means precede those who are asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, comfort one another with these words. Amen.
Amen. Therefore, comfort one another. Amen. The late Felicia Rockson, popularly known as Auntie Felicia, is the reason why we're here. Anytime we meet writers, whether we stand at the graveside, we are reminded of the shadow that has been cast over our humanity. And all this stems from the fact that Adam sinned. We are reminded that death happens to all of us one way or other. And that is because we live in a fallen, imperfect world. We are reminded of our failings, our shortcomings, our flaws, and our limitations. Paul said in Romans 5:12 that through one man, sin entered the world, and death through sin. And thus death spread to all men, because all remind us of this universal problem that we have. Why? Because God did not leave us in that valley or under the shadow. As believers, when we get to know God and the truth of this scripture, we realize that death also brings to us a very precious realization. We realize that God has a solution for any problems that we have. Therefore, the passage of scripture in Romans 5:12 does not go far enough to give us the entire picture. There is no doubt that what we have experienced right now, which is the unexpected the truth of Scripture, and especially surround Charlotte and her family with all our love, our faith, and our prayers. You see, Aunt Felicia had a relationship that carried some wonderful promise, the promise found in John chapter 14, verse 1 to 3, which we have just read. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. I can only go by what I know of Aunt Felicia. And from the passage of scripture that we have just read, because we have not got plenty of time, we need to be here, out of here, but in 40 minutes. So the time is actually quite precious. I have chosen three words that describes her. The first word that I have chosen is loving. This wonderful woman was a loving wife, mother, and grandmother. She loved everybody and went out of her way to express this love to everyone. She was always ready to tell anyone in need. But most importantly, she loved her Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. She loved him with all her heart. The other word is cheerful. Aunt Felicia was always, she always had a smile for everyone. And when she is greeting you, she has this warm, pleasant voice to greet you with. And whilst you are in her presence, she makes you feel as if you are the most important person on earth. That is who she was. Aunt Felicia was also one of the founding members of Christ Victory Church. Members and a pillar of Christ Victory Church ministry. She was very generous, very caring, always ready and eager to volunteer. Oh, cooking. She would want to feed you till you want no more, which is when I consider the takeaways, or doggy bags, or whatever you choose to call it. She was always ready to help in any way that she could. My last word is faithful. Auntie Felicia is someone that you could always depend on her. When she said that she will help or do something, you can bet that she will do it. She was faithful in her ministry, worshiping her Lord and Savior. And I'm sure Charlotte will attest to this, that when it came to the things of God, as she was growing up, not going to church was not an option. Hallelujah. It wasn't an option or, you know, a topic that we have to debate about. She, when it comes to the things of God, she was so faithful. Aunt Felicia is really a great example for our ministry. Being faithful right to the very end. If I am to sum it up, Auntie Felicia has left a great legacy for her family, for the ministry and friends. All these special traits, that is what this wonderful woman exhibited while she was on earth. And what that means is that she will never be forgotten. Never forgotten by her family and friends, and certainly not by Christ Victory Church members. I'm reminded that there is a grandson, Levi, so please just forgive me for not mentioning Levi's name. Auntie Felicia has stepped into the portals of glory, and I know that she was happily greeted by her beloved husband, who recently passed away. I can only imagine that I do understand that he whistled a lot. So I can imagine that he would have whistled her name as he used to do, and said to her, "I'm so glad to see you. I have been waiting for you." Auntie Felicia was the kind of person that gives us one more reason for making heaven our home. We want to see her again and walk and dance with her on those streets. Those streets that are paved. Jesus Christ said to her, "Well done, thou good and faithful servant. Enter into the joy of the Lord." What a wonderful hope. The passage of scripture that we read in 1 Thessalonians 4, 13 to 18 is so vivid. But I do not want you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning those who have fallen asleep, lest you sorrow as others who have no hope. So the scripture is confirming that our position as believers is very different. So this is very encouraging. Hallelujah. And thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, comfort one another with these words. Notice how beautiful and how powerful those words are. That we shall always be with the Lord. There will be no isolation in heaven. We will not be separated from each other. Heaven for us will be a place of perpetual reunion. Timothy also had this precious realization that God has acted on our behalf and provided us for us a greater answer to the need that we have as human beings. It is for this reason that the psalmist said in Psalm 23, verse 4, our realization, it says, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. Our realization, and indeed our proclamation today, is that life has triumphed over death. Mercy and grace have triumphed over sin. Justification has triumphed over condemnation. We have a precious realization today, and that leads us into what Corinthians said. 1 Corinthians 15, verse 51 to 55. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall all sleep, but we shall all be changed. And in that part is what really gladdens my heart. Death is one that can be true. Oh, death, where is thy sting? Oh, grave, where is thy victory? Felicia Rockson is not here. She stands in the presence of our Lord. The same Jesus who said to the dying man on the cross, that today you shall be with me in paradise. The body that lies before us must be earthly tabernacle. That's what it is. The house which Auntie Felicia lived among us for a time. So tenderly and with deep solid respect, we will be committing that house to the grave. To God.
Felicia Akyere Rockson was born 17th October 1947 in Takoradi, Ghana, to the late Mr. James Eko Rockson and Madam Mary Ifuadazi, nicknamed Matsawonka, also known as Marks. Felicia's childhood was a happy one. Felicia started her schooling at the age of 6. She attended Methodist primary school and regularly attended church most Sundays. Felicia developed to become a popular pupil in school. Due to her strong characteristics, she was appointed school prefect. Felicia was actively involved in day-to-day school activities. At the age of 8 years old, her father came and took her to Dwumfour, to his mother's house, until she went to Accra Girls. When she finished, Felicia came to England, United Kingdom in 1967 to study law and remain in the UK ever since. It was in the UK where Felicia met the charming and handsome late Mr. Desmond Thompson Corty. They became husband and wife, and in 1979, they had a beautiful daughter, Charlotte Vera Irama Chiba Thompson Korte, their only child. In July 1978, Felicia enjoyed a wonderful career in Metropolitan Police catering. Then in 1993, changed career to go into health and social care, where she worked till she retired in 2010. Felicia was so hardworking, taking care of the family home as well. She managed to do both very well. Felicia was an educated Christian. She took her faith very seriously. She loved God and always put God first. She was such a prayerful woman. She loved to help family and friends whenever she could and was much loved by her friends and family, especially her husband, daughter, and grandchildren. Whenever Felicia was around, you knew to be fun and interesting. She never tolerated any nonsense. As time went on, Felicia's health deteriorated and was unable to go out as much as she used to. She loved Charlotte so much, her only daughter, and would do anything for her. She had four wonderful grandchildren and a loving son-in-law whom she adored greatly and spent most of her time with them and with Desmond until his demise. Felicia Akyere Rockson breathed her last breath on 6 October 2021 with her daughter Charlotte and son-in-law Donald by her side. Her departure, although painful to see, she went peacefully back to her heavenly father, the year.
From you.
Daughter's tribute, Charlotte Vera Thompson Porte, which will be read by Liana.
Dear sweet mommy, there are not enough words in existence to describe how I'm feeling. How I miss you so much. Is too much to comprehend and bear. You made my mind make sense. Your godly guidance has helped shape my life and the lives of my children too. My heart has been crushed. I did my duty to the end till I could do no more. As I was watching you slowly passing away, it was the hardest thing to see. Each day, telling me off, me laughing and getting you annoyed thinking I'm not taking you seriously. You taught me the value of hard work and to always rely on God as He knows best. I sincerely, I know you are watching over me with Daddy. Both have gone so suddenly. I pray for understanding as to why you and Daddy had to go and leave me so soon. Life is not and will not be the same. The loneliness is so unreal, but you taught me that all plans, that all pain shall pass and never lose sight of God. You loved me unconditionally and were the best mother anyone could ever wish for. I miss you. I love you so much. Till we meet again, Day and Mummy.
What a powerful tribute. I'd like to call the grandchildren to read their call. And it's going to be read by Shimmy.
Grandma, your life was full of loving deeds. You gave us unconditional love. You taught us to love and trust God and to pray always. This lesson is helping us to get through the pain of losing you. Grandma, you made us all your favorite in a way. Only you could do. We cherish the memories of you close to our hearts, the many fun times we had, the stories you told us, the food you used to cook us. We are proud to call you our grandma and will always do our best to make you proud of us in all we do. You have now been called to be one of God's angels, so we now have a new guardian angel watching over us for the rest of our lives. You will always live in our hearts. We love you forever. Rest well, Grandma, in God's eternal peace. You've earned it.
So it's not just me who has been enjoying the food. The next tribute, I think we need to really race through the program. The next tribute by best friend is going to be read by Mami and Sik.
Felicia Rockson, as I affectionately called her, was born on the 17th of October 1947. We first met on my first day at the Cra Girls Secondary School in September 1962. We hit it off spontaneously and remained loyal to each other till her demise on the 6th of October 2021. Felicia only called me by my family name, Dwumfour, and was the only person who called me by that name. She was the blue-eyed daughter of her father, the late Mr. J.K. Rockson, who thought the world of her. Because of our closeness, J.K. took me in as another daughter of his, so that Felicia could have a close companion. We remained inseparable and did everything together during our school years. We were only separated by our dormitories, Felicia in Greenhouse Dorm 4 and I in Whitehouse Dorm 2. When J.K. visited us at school, whatever he bought was for the two of us, and when my mum visited, everything again was for the two of us. When we were not at school, JK had us chauffeur-driven wherever we went. We spent the half-term holidays with JK and Auntie Julie at Asylum Down, where Felicia owned the outhouse. Being Felicia's companion thrilled JK and loved to see us together. During school holidays, we spent time at Asylum Down and the other half with my parents in Second E, and Felicia's mother at Newtown Valley until the end of holidays and travelled together to school. Felicia was a great laugh with a fantastic sense of humour, a split image of her father. At school she was very brave, full of mischief and not scared of anyone, and used to say to us, "I don't fear whom." At one time, when the lights went off for bed, Felicia was still in the White House visiting friends. Suddenly everybody started running for dear life because Mrs. Paulina Buckman, the housemistress, the strictest disciplinarian of the White House, was coming to do her rounds. Attempting to run to the greenhouse, she bumped into Mrs. Buckman in total darkness and pushed her to clear her off. Mrs. Buckman turned on her torch and said who she was, and Felicia melted into a pulp and ran away. Next day, she narrated everything to me, and she said for the first time she experienced palpitations. I said to her, "But you always said you don't fear who." Felicia left Ghana for the UK as soon as we finished Form 5 in 1967, and I followed suit in 1969. We met and continued our friendship from where we left off in Ghana. She had met her partner, Mr. Desmond Owen Thompson Corte. When I got married to Papa Pine, we became a foursome, and we met at our individual homes in Stevenage and Belvedere, respectively. Desmond and Felicia had their daughter Charlotte on the 22nd of September 1979, and we had Abba and Issy in 1977 and 1979, and the three became a threesome too. Felicia and I always had something to talk and laugh about, especially our days at Accra Girls. This made Desmond to remark, "After all these years, we still had a lot to talk about." He often said, "Felicia always doted on me, and I was her everything, a sister, a true friend, and a confidant." He said a lot of times, "Dwumfour, I don't know what Felicia would do without you." It really saddens me that in her last moment, I was so far away in Ghana. How I wish I was at her bedside, holding her as she took her last breath. Felicia, sleep well. I will miss you, but thank God for almost 60 years we shared so much, and we were there for each other. Till we meet again, fare thee well.
Thank you. I think we'll move on to ask the family to come up so that Pastor Mama will pray. Thank you.
plants or a fruit or anything, it does germinate. But what about human beings? When they are buried, they never germinate. But by faith, we believe that our auntie, our mom, our mother-in-law, our grandma, our friend, and everything has been called home to the Lord. Father, we commit the entire family into your holy hands. Guard and protect them. Anyone who fights against any of them is fighting against you, Lord. You are their protector. Help them to live a life that Auntie lived. And Auntie lived just as Christ helped her to live. And we believe at the end of the day, all of us will meet again. Father, you have assured us that if only we trust in you and do as you teach us to do, we shall never die. Physically, we may die, but spiritually, yes, forever we shall live with you. Thank you, Master, for answering the prayer. And let the saints say, Amen.
Amen.
God bless you all.
Amen. Please remain standing as we receive the benediction. And then we will follow the coffin to the graveside. And Pastor, our general overseer, will take over from there. Now, may the God of peace, who brought up our Lord Jesus Christ from the dead, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you complete in every good work to do his will, working in you what is well-pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen.
Take me to you. Thank you. Thank you. Hmm?
Wonderful moment. From the time that we knew her to the very moment we are saying that we are burying her, we've been faithful to be here with her. May the Lord bless you all. And it is not the first time we've been in cemeteries, if not the first time we've heard people being buried or someone being buried. and it's not going to be the last time. One thing we have to know, everyone here, one day, no matter how strong you are, someone will have to carry you and put you in there. And the Lord says something in Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verse 1, and says, to everything there is a season. There's a time to be born and a time to be buried. And this is the time that we have to think about ourselves. Who is it that has hurt you? Let it go. Being a human being, someone will hurt you. But let it go. I learned from one typical example, 2 weeks before our mommy or auntie passed away. I was just sitting beside her. The Lord said that I want to call her, tell her to forgive anyone that has sinned against her. And then she also has to ask for forgiveness because I'm going to call her. It was difficult for me to tell her. That means that she's going to die. Prayers as pastors, we always pray that the person will come back to life or get out of the sick bed. But I got the message that she was going to pass on to a better world in the name of the Lord. When I turned around and told her, she looked at me quietly and smiled. She said, I will forgive and ask for forgiveness. She did it and finished, and the Lord said, to lead her to become reborn again. Give her life back to the Lord Jesus. And just after that, the energy that she had to sing with me, that one I videoed and sent to beloved children, that's beloved son, and then the beloved daughter. She sang with me and laughed so much. That was the joy that she had to go. God never leaves his children. Let us all know where we have to be. And you see that Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verses 6 and 7. It says, remember your creator before the golden bowl will break. That is before your heart will stop functioning. There is going to be a time that it will be too late. You will wish you will jump and dance for God, but it will be too late. You will wish that you go before someone and apologize, it will be too late. Even to forgive, let us have a heart of forgiveness in the name of the Lord Jesus. He said that then the dust will return to the earth as it was. As it was. It means that the body itself is from the dust and it will go back into the dust. We have to think all the things that we are wearing, all the shaping of our beard and the hairstyle and the makeup and everything. It is like cooking and then just putting things around, making the seasoning, the aroma coming out. It's for the worms and the maggots. It's nothing. So as we are here, we have to think about God, where we will be going in future, not what we are having here on earth. What we have on here on earth is how it's happening. You see that? And it will go back to the earth where it was. And then and the spirit will return to God who gave it. But when it goes before God, that is where it is that the account that you have to Hebrews chapter 9, verse 27. He said that as it is appointed for man to live, and when you die once, then it's dead. When the Lord called you, they called you tomorrow. What are you going to be? What is going to be your judgment? Are you going to heaven? Are you going to hell? I do something very well for me. When the Lord said, tell her to give her life back to me. Jesus Christ. Yeah. Chapter 8, verse 8a. I love it. He said, no one has power over the spirit to retain the spirit. And no one has the power in the day of death. The day and the time that the Lord will come to call us, there's no one that will hold on to it. No matter who you are, how you are, you will go. But how you have to go, you have to prepare. Our mother, as it was said, started with the ministry. And there was a time people were saying, Osman, go and form a church, we'll follow you. Don't move when the Lord hasn't told you to move. When the Lord said, I will open your eyes, watch. Only five people among all the people around me, only five people were standing there. It was our mother, Felicia, and Charlotte, our beloved sister. Among the people, they were standing there. All the people from a church, they were not there. And that's how it is. Do not let anyone push you where God has not told you to go. They will let you down.
May God bless us. We started chapter 4, verse 1. He said, all go to one place. All are from the dust. And all return to the dust. This is the very moment it is. And when God is with you, he started with our sister, mama, our mother, our grandma. The day that the Lord called her, I was thinking, I haven't heard from Mr. Shalom. The whole day, the whole day, the doctor see a report that was given. And that was after 3 a.m. I was wondering, I was just worried, I could not sleep. I sent text message to her. What are the doctors saying about mama? 5 minutes later, she called me. I said, sorry, I didn't want to disturb you. He said, no. The doctors called me to tell me that I haven't been seeing you lately. I didn't know the God is still with her, telling her that she can't be healthy. God watches over us. He will never leave us nor forsake us. Let us give our lives to the Lord. Whatever we are doing, we should depend on the Lord. And as she gave her life to the Lord Jesus, I pray that anyone that is willing to also become born again, give your life to the Lord. Within 2 minutes, you say after me, please. Heavenly Father, I stand before you. I'm sorry for my sins. I renounce them all. I give my life unto you. That from today going, I will serve you only in the name of the Lord Jesus. Satan, I renounce you and your cohorts in the name of the Lord Jesus. Anything you have within me, I reject them all. And anything mine that is with you, I take it in Jesus' name. So Satan and your cohorts, I command you to leave me right now in Jesus' name. Holy Spirit, I invite you to come into my life and use me for your glory. In Jesus' name I pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you, we give all the glory. You say, if one soul is won in heaven, but here on earth, all the angels in heaven are jubilating. We know that, Father, many have given their lives to you. Let your hand continue to guide us and protect us. In the mighty and powerful name of the Lord Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Now, finally, our auntie, our mommy, our daughter, our grandma will have to be where she belongs to now. So, please. As we are supporting to bury our auntie, so shall we not be trapped anywhere. We will also be lovingly, by loving and caring family members, bury us the same way in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
The cross.
Lord died on the cross, that I might have life.
My Lord died on the cross, that I
my redeemer, my redeemer, my redeemer. Yeah, that was Sinova, Yawa, Yamaya. Thank you.